morning, students of class 7. After summer vacation, we are again joining the online classes. Today, I am going to start chapter 9 in your geometry. Here, in geometry, this one is called the lines and angles. The chapter's name is lines and angles. Lines and angles. Now, today I am going to discuss with, first thing is adjacent angle, adjacent angle, second one is linear pair exam, first I discuss these two, then there is another. Complementary angle, supplementary angle, vertically opposite angles. This one we have to discuss today. Is it clear? First thing is what is adjacent angle. See what I am teaching you. This one is very important. Even in upper classes, the students do not understand the adjacent angles. So, what is adjacent angle? If first point is that they have common vertex, they have common vertex. What is the meaning of this one? Common vertex means these two angles are forming at a point. So that is they have a common vertex. Second thing is that they have one common arm. They have one common arm. And C is that the other two arms are on the either side, on the other sides of the common arm. The other two sides, the other arms of the angle on either side of the common arm. First you know this one, then by diagram I will show you what are the adjacent angles. Two angles are said to be adjacent if they have common vertex, that the angle is formed at the common point. They have one common arm. The two angles must have a common arm. And the other two arms are on the either side of the common arm. So that is there. Then the angles are said to be adjacent. For example, see here. First you write down this one. I have told you twice. So you can write that an adjacent angle have one common arm, one common vertex, and the other two arms are just opposing to the common arm. Here you see here two angles are there. Angle AOC and AOB. Check here, in angle AOB and angle AOC, this one is one angle, this one is another angle. Both angles are formed out of the common vertex. This common vertex is equal to O. Both the angles are forming on O. So first is completed. One common arm that is equal to OA. OA is present in both the angles. Angle AOB also contains OA, and angle AOC there is OA. So the common arc is OA. So that is the second one is fulfilled. And third one is that the other two arms are on the either side of the common arc OA. That is OB, OB and OC are on either side of OA. That is OB, you are finding that this side right hand side, and this one is OC is the left side. So these two arms are on the either side of OA. So angle AOB, so from here I can say that angle AOB and AO and AOC are adjacent angles. I think that you understand. If you are not understanding, so we are going to do another example. One more example I am taking for you. Now, linear pair axiom. What is axiom? There is a difference between axiom and theorem. Axiom is self-proof, no need to prove it. And theorem, that we have to prove that one. So, if it forms a linear pair, then what may happen? According to linear pair, angle AOC plus angle BOC is equal to 180 degree. So this one is called, whenever you write this one, you have to write linear pair axiom, which is self-proof. As this line is a straight line, so we say this pair is called linear pair. Is it clear? So you understand linear pair axiom. The third part was complementary axiom. So here you see in a linear pair, here AOC and BOC was our adjacent angle because it has a common vertex, common arm, and other two arms are on the either side. But the other two arms are just opposite to each other, then we say that it forms a linear pair. And whenever it forms a linear pair, this one is called axiom, and that is called linear pair axiom. That is, it forms 180 degree. Now we come to the next part, that is complementary and supplementary axioms. Two angles are said to be complement of each other or complementary angle if their sum is complementary angle, the sum of two angles is 90 degree, then each angle is said to be the complement of other. Here you find out, if I have to find 15 degree, then 75 degree, 60 degree, what will be its complement? Complement will be 90 minus 50, 90 minus 75, 90 minus 60. That is equal to 75 degree, this one is 15 degree, this one is 30 degree. So then, if it is x, then the complement will be 90 minus x. If it is theta, then 90 minus theta. This one is called the complements of this angle. So if the sum of two angles is 90 degree, then each angle is said to be the complement of the other. Then the next one is supplementary angle. If the sum of two angles is 180 degree, then the angles are said to be supplement to each other. If the sum of two angles is 180 degree, then each angle is said to be the supplement of a if this one is 70 degree angle, supplement will be 180 minus 70, degree, that is equal to 110 degree. If it is x, then this one will be 180 minus x degree. Then if it is x plus 10, then the supplement of x plus 10 will be equal to 180 minus x plus 10. Then wherever it is sought, it would be equal to 180 minus x minus 10, that is 170 minus x. Is it clear? So we are able to find out the supplement. Then the one more thing is that the vertically opposite angles, whenever two lines intersect each other, then four angles are formed there. Let us consider that two sides A, B, C, D is intersecting at 4. Then this angle AOC is just opposite to angle BOD, so that is called vertically opposite angle. Angle AOC will be equal to angle BOD, and angle BOC is equal to angle AOD. This one is called vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles are equal. This angle is called the vertically angle of this one. This one is, if this one is x, this one will be x. If this one is y, this one will be equal to y. Is it clear? So these two angles are said to be vertically opposite, and this one is vertically opposite to this one, and the vertically opposite angles are equal. So only theory part I have done today, and next day we will start. Next day we will start exercise 9.1, and that day I will complete that one. So you should know these things, whenever I will teach you, okay.